This is a production of PBS 39.
Well, imagine trying to live healthier without having a place to call home. According to a 2005 study, families make up 41% of the homeless population, yet most shelters don't allow families to stay together. However, a shelter in Allentown thinks the best way to get people back on their feet is by sticking together. Crystal Fisher has more.
Sifting through classifieds and circling job listings have become daily rituals for Tracy and Javier Lunkarnik. With a family of five and just one part-time job between the two of them, they found it impossible to make ends meet.
I was working, but then I had to quit my job because I had no babysitter.
The family's only income now comes from disability checks for their daughter, who was born with a cleft palate, and the $300 Javier makes as a dishwasher. At the end of the month, there isn't enough to pay rent and keep food on the table. They recently lost their apartment.
Paying like $500-$600 a month for a three-bedroom. Plus, I had to pay all my utilities, though, too.
There just wasn't enough money to go around, so they turned to the 6th Street Shelter in Allentown, the only area shelter that allows families to stay together. Caseworker supervisor Donna Pavone says keeping a family together increases their chances of staying off the streets.
It's important for the stability of the family, because obviously it's very important for the husband and the wife to stay together, for the stability of their children.
Because I can work day shift and he works night shift. And then, so he said he'll watch the kids while I work during the day.
It is scary because, you know, I think that a lot of us are not more than a couple paychecks away from, you know, being behind on our bills and getting evicted.
The program director, Marcia Eichelberger, sees people enter the shelter for many different reasons.
We've had families that have come in because of fires in their apartment. We've had families come in because of lead issues in their apartment. We've had families come in because they fall behind on their rent.
And the list goes on. The shelter is not emergency housing, so in order to stay in one of the 19 apartments, residents must have children, earn some income, be actively searching for a job, and can stay no longer than 2 months. That helps them save money to put a down payment on an apartment. Marcia believes the shelter should be more than just a place to stay.
We have a waiting list of 2 months for families that want to come into the shelter. So you have an opportunity while you're here to really focus on the issues that got you here and work with the caseworkers.
Well, we're not an emergency shelter, so you must have a referral in order to come to us.
Once a family's accepted, caseworkers like Don Murphy teach them practical survival skills, like budgeting, taking care of their children, and much more, with the hopes of them not winding up homeless again. Beyond the two-month stay at the 6th Street shelter, residents like Shamika Clark, who want to get an education, can apply for one of the 22 long-term units that the shelter operates. The Turner Street and Ferry Street apartments are a little different. You have to pay 30% of your income towards rent, which can be anything from welfare to a full-time job. You can stay in the housing for up to 2 years, but you must have children under 18 and be working towards a higher education.
I'm working full-time. I'm a student full-time, and I'm a parent full-time. Peekaboo.
Shamika makes a little time in the afternoon to play peekaboo and put together puzzles with her son before she has to head off to her associate's degree program from 6 to 10. In the morning, she works full-time as a grill cook at Muhlenberg College. So between a quick nap and getting ready for class, she doesn't have a whole lot of free time, but she doesn't mind.
Right now, my goals are to finish school, raise my son, hopefully by the time I'm 30, have my own business.
Shamika's family recently moved back to New York City, leaving her and her son homeless.
I've never been out on my own before. Just decided that I needed to do it.
Having nowhere to go, this 26-year-old single mother put her name on the waiting list at the shelter. There, caseworkers taught her how to keep a clean and safe home and dedicate herself to a job. After graduating the shelter, she applied for their long-term housing. Now she's on her way to making her dreams come true, and she's not the only one.
Last year, we housed 95 families, and that included 285 children, most of them under the age of five.
With the shelter's help, both the Clarks and the Lunkarniks are looking ahead to the future.
Teach my son better things that I was taught when I was younger, and for him to be a strong like me.
A quiet neighborhood for them, that they can play outside and act.
And with the tools they learned at the 6th Street Shelter, both families hope to make a brighter future for their children. For Tempo, I'm Crystal Fisher reporting.